What's going on, all of you fantastic freelancers? My name is William, the host of your Anthem, and today we have a very special guest. He is the one, the only, Mr. Baggs from Anthem Insider. How are you doing today, good buddy?
Hey, William, I'm doing great, man. Thanks for having me on.
Let's see, this is, what, the second time you've been on your Anthem? Beforehand, what was it? I think it was like Gamescom, or was it PAX West where you came on and we did our predictions for it?
Before PAX, it was before PAX.
Well, I'm thrilled that you could take some time out of your busy schedule to, I guess, sit down, record an interview.
Anytime, man. For you, anytime.
Thanks, buddy. So I want to get to know you a little bit more before we get into Anthem Insider. So who is Baggs? What are you? Who are you?
Ooh, that's a tough one. How do I start and like keep it short? Well, I'm 33 years old currently, and I've always loved video games, man. I think the very first one I played was like Arkanoid on some tabletop in some electronics repair shop. My father used to take our broken TV all the time. From there, I moved on to consoles and like, you know, Gran Turismo and all that in the 90s. And once I got my hands on a computer around like 98, that was it. Like Doom.
That was it. No more consoles. PC Master Race.
PC only, man. Like Doom and all that good stuff. And then all the good stuff since then. CS.
Yeah, and you're also known as the man with the silver gray hair.
People get on my stream on Twitch and they start calling me like either like old man or like silver fox, all that kind of funny stuff.
See, I didn't know that you were 33 years old. You're really young to be having gray hair. When did that start coming in?
Dude, I started having gray hair around like 20, like a few hair here and there, but at 25, I had like half my hair was gray. So I'm already used to it by now. I like it actually.
I know that you're from Greece. What's it like though, being a YouTuber in Greece with your primary market being in like America and Europe?
Oh man, that is a tough one. You gotta be able to speak proper English. I hope mine is like decent enough. It looks like it's working so far.
I mean, it's top notch.
Thank you. Other than that, it's a lot of people do it, but many focus in the Greek community, or so to speak, or the Greek audience, and I feel that's very limiting. There's like 11 million people in Greece. How many of them are gamers? How many of those are interested in something specific you're going to be creating content about? So I had to, you know, to stand out or to reach a wider audience, you have to speak English and stay up late. I'm 8 hours ahead of the US. So whenever you guys are like having lunch, I'm having dinner. And when you guys are having dinner, I should be sleeping for like 5 hours. So there's a lot of sleepless nights, and it's worth it though. It's fun.
What's the gaming industry like in Greece? You mentioned 11 million people in Greece, and I know we've had this conversation before, but to enlighten everyone, what's it kind of like in Greece for the gaming market, at least for the gaming industry?
Anything that's free to play.
Would you say a lot of Greek people are gamers?
I would say a big percentage, yes. It started with like Counter-Strike back in the 2000s. We got internet like a bit later. Like the US already had broadband around 98, 99. We got it around 2000, 2001, like widely available. And like the first online games were MU Online, and the majority of online Greek gamers, you know, it boomed around the CSGO era with like 1.5, 1.6. And then Lineage happened and the private servers and all that. Greece and the gamers, they have a special, you know, interest in pirated games and free, anything that's free works. So a lot of the internet places here, like internet cafes, they were packed with people, right? And everybody would play Lineage on private servers and things like that.
So what made you decide to do content creation?
I really don't know. I just thought I would give it a try, and then people actually watched some of my videos or some of the stuff I made or some of the articles I wrote, and they enjoyed them. And I'm like, this is fun. Let's keep going. And it went from there.
Was Anthem Insider your first ever like content creation platform, or did you have another name brand, or is this Anthem Insider your first attempt?
As an owner or something, yeah, Anthem Insider is my first. But in the past, I've had, you know, some, I've written some articles here and there, and people really like them. Because I have this thing in my head, like, I read-proof my thing. And even though it might have some grammatical errors, if I like it, if I like what is written, then I feel like a lot of people are going to like it as well, because I'm very strict with myself. Before Anthem Insider, it was just like here and there. I tried some things. I tried to land some jobs.
So inspiration is everything to a content creator. I know for me, it's my community, getting to meet people like you. I mean, especially people like you. And also Anthem, the game. I mean, it's got this massive, beautiful story. Those are my inspirations. That's what makes me produce content. So what about you? What are your biggest inspirations for Anthem Insider?
Definitely the game. I see it more from a journalistic point of view. I want to learn about it. I want to know what's going on behind the scenes. Is everything okay over there in BioWare, EA? Is the game following, you know, the schedule? Is it on track? Is it releasing on time? Is there any talks of like a delay or something? I see it that way. Also, like you said, the people, the Anthem Insider community really hugged me, man. They really restored my faith in humanity.
They sent you to Gamescom, didn't they?
They did, yeah. They paid the tickets for the plane. They were very expensive. I'm very thankful for that. Without going very emotional about it, the people definitely, but at the same time, the journalistic point of view, I want to learn about it, learn everything there is about the game. In this particular instance, it's Anthem. Maybe later down the road, I'm going to cover another game as well. I don't know. Whatever interests me, I want to learn everything about it. That's my inspiration.
I guess that kind of piggybacks off on my next question. What drew you to Anthem? I know Anthem, it was just an interest in BioWare for me. I mean, I thought it was a really cool new IP. I've been a massive Fact guy, I've been a SWOTOR, KOTOR guy. So what was it that drew you to Anthem?
The 2017 gameplay trailer and the gameplay that they showed. It's very rare these days to see a company announce a new game and show gameplay from it straight away. It's mostly cinematics, it's mostly CGI, but with Anthem, even though, you know, the scenes with Praxley and some other stuff that were rendered in engine and they were a little bit, you know, CGI, the second part of the trailer, it was pure gameplay, and I was like blown away. I'm like, even if it was all there was, it still looked incredible. It looked like a world I would like to log on right away and start playing with friends and making new friends and shooting things and chasing that gear and that stuff, right? Games are inherently pretty much the same. You kill something, you complete an objective and then you get a reward, but it looked so beautiful and it looked so something we haven't seen before, like the flight mechanic and all that. That's
oh
exactly
my God. Tell me
yeah
about it.
It was a combination of, hey, this company showing gameplay for the first time they're showing their game at E3, and that doesn't really happen if the developer isn't comfortable about their game. And then the world was stunning, and then the gameplay was just sold me to it, right?
So we know a little bit more about you now, we know a little bit about your inspirations, and we know what drew you to Anthem. So how did Anthem Insider get its start?
So a lot of people are not gonna know about this, but I did not start it.
Wait, what?
Yes, I took over Anthem Insider on March this year, 2018, and I worked really hard on it since. Previously, somebody else had started it, but for his own reasons, he wanted to, he wanted to shut it down. And I'm like, wait, what? Please don't do that, because the game is going to be shown at E3 in 4 months from now, and whatever reasons there are, we can work them out, right? We can make it work. It's just a couple months. Just hang in there. But for his own personal reasons, I guess, he just gave the ownership over to me, and whatever other members were involved, they were all like vanished at that point, because the project was private up to that point. So I took over on March, and I'm the owner now, but I didn't start it.
So tell me a little bit about your trip to Gamescom with Anthem Insider. I mean, we mentioned your community helped fund you to go over there. What was your experience like over there in Gamescom in Germany?
I still don't believe I went.
If it weren't for the pictures, you didn't go.
Yeah, I still poke my wife every now and then. I'm like, hey, do you believe we went to Gamescom like a few months ago? And it's kind of like it hasn't resonated with me yet. I used to like watch all the trailers that came out or the news that came out from it and the videos and the interviews and all that and the pictures online. And I'm like, man, I want to go there like once, right? At least once. So it happened with Anthem, I guess, and Anthem Insider. And I really gotta thank once again the Anthem Insider community for donating all the money, man, for the for the tickets because EA did not sponsor my trip. I did not expect them to. It's just that they did not. I'm a person who doesn't feel comfortable with the concept of flight. So getting on a plane and going somewhere, it was surreal. I'm like, am I really doing this? This is like something I told myself I wouldn't really do. But I did, and everything went fine, and we arrived. And actually, one of the Anthem Insider community members let us stay at his place for a full week for free. So yeah, like I keep telling this, but I can't stress it enough. Without the Anthem Insider community, it wouldn't have been possible for me to go there, get a hands-on, you know, write the articles and have an honest opinion about the game, because between you and me, like, I'm just a random gamer, right? So other than that, it was great. You could start a conversation with anyone. There were people all over the place, all over, all the booths were visited more than once by people. So many cool games shown, other than Anthem, of course.
Right, other than Anthem. But I want to touch on something really quick. You mentioned community, and I think the Anthem Insider and the Your Anthem community are among the two of the best communities out there, for Anthem at least. I mean, my guys are huge fans of yours, and we love everything you do, and it's just so neat. Like, your guys sponsor you to go to Gamescom. You got to stay with one of them. My guys helped me finance my computer to get back into content creation after my laptop finally bit the dust. I mean, I wouldn't be here talking to you, being able to produce this video without their support. And not to mention, just the other day, we had two of the community members meet up for lunch that were complete and total strangers before.
Yeah, I saw that.
That's just so neat.
That was wholesome.
It's very surreal. The communities, I just thought I was this was a hobby. I was some random content creator, and I'm sure you felt the same. And then,
oh yeah,
the community came, and then it felt very surreal. It's very humbling, and I don't think either of us, I know neither of us would be where we are right now without our incredible communities.
Definitely, William. They are the ones behind this, behind Anthem Insider, behind Your Anthem, behind any project, any content creator. Without the people watching, without the people, you know, reading the articles, commenting, you know, tuning in for the streams, chatting, and all that, it doesn't work. You can put in as much work as you want, but without a community behind it, it's not going to work, right? It's not going to be effective. It's like friendship, basically, but long distance. You haven't met these people, but they're pretty much your friends at this point.
Yeah, the Your Anthem community is like a small family. Most of us, at least, we're all like a little family right there. And I love it. I've never experienced anything like this before. So sincerely, to the Anthem Insider community and the Your Anthem community, I mean, we love you. We love you guys.
Yeah, dudes, you're awesome.
So I want to talk about you meeting John Warner. I mean, that's kind of like meeting the Walt Disney of Anthem. It's funny because he used to work for Disney, but what was it like meeting John Warner? What kind of guy is he?
John has charisma. He really does. It sounds like a fanboy thing, but
I mean, we are fanboys.
Obviously, he stands out. You can tell he's someone that has had this career of his because of his personality and the way he thinks and acts and all that. He somehow expresses that in a physical form somehow. I could tell that he was cool, and you know, he suggested to take a picture and all that. He was cool. He wasn't like, hey, I'm kind of busy, like, come back in a minute. No, he was like, hey, I'm here, like, we can talk, ask me whatever you want. And he was pretty cool.
He seems like such a calm and happy guy. And I mean, I've bragged on our developers before. I mean, we have some of the best devs ever. We've got John Warner, we got Mark Dare, we got Mike Gamble, we got Ben Irving. And the list goes on and on and on. We've got some incredible developers on Anthem, and people like John Warner only give me further faith and investment that Anthem will succeed, and it will be a game-changing game, if you will.
You see all these people online, and we see their pictures and their interviews and all that, and they seem unapproachable and hard, quote unquote, but they aren't. They're actually gamers just like you and I, and whenever they got free time, they're just gonna like game on their phone or on their console or PC or whatever. Like, they're pretty much like everybody else. They're regular people with like a decent and important job, a decent career, right, on their backs. That's all there is.
Like Mike Gamble, I see him tweet every now and again that he's playing Overwatch on PS4 or John Warner's playing Spider-Man on the PS4. I mean, it's neat. They're gamers too, making a game for gamers. It just comes full circle. It's really neat. And speaking of really neat, you got to play Anthem while you were at Gamescom. You are amongst the very few of us, content creators at least, who've gotten to play it. So what was it like?
That's one thing I still do not believe either. You go into that room, they tell you to, it's time to get up and like get inside, and they give you the controller, you sit down and you're out and you haven't even realized. The demo, when you watch it, is like 20 minutes long. It must have taken 30 minutes for us. I thought it was 30 seconds. You don't have time to process everything that's going on. You're getting a lot of new information. It's a new game, obviously. They're telling you the controls. You start going and they're like, follow me and stuff. And you don't really have time to look around, check the menus or stop and stare stuff or explore stuff. So what I played was exactly what you saw, the E3 demo gameplay on YouTube. It was just, you know, I played it from the perspective of the Ranger, and I was basically just trying to keep up, because apparently, Zach, if you're watching this, you didn't tell me that there's a speed, you know, there's a speed dial. So I was flying at the lowest flight speed and trying to keep up. So, you know, it's a hard game. It's not an easy game. It's not going to be for everyone. Definitely not. Especially like mechanics. There's the controls. There's the details you need to know. It's not, you know, a casual game. I don't think it is a casual game. You can approach it casually, I guess. But at the same time, what I played, the Stronghold, it was hard.
Well, I can imagine all those creepy crawly spiders that you need to burn with a flamethrower. I mean, I gotcha.
There's plenty of ways to do it. You can block the spider webs with the Colossal Shield. You can dodge them if you're flying with the Storm or the Ranger. You can barrel or blink. There's strategy. So the boss battle, and something I want to stress, and that many people might not realize, it's more like a World of Warcraft dungeon boss. It looks like it has phases and certain attacks that happen at certain intervals, and you gotta watch for them. There's like a signal before them, like the monster does something before it does a specific attack. So without doing it a couple times, I don't think you're gonna be clearing it, you know, unscathed and without any bruises.
Yeah, did you go down at all?
I would if the god mode was not turned on.
Oh, okay, I see.
I would have died at least twice.
At least twice. So yeah. I also have to say, really quickly, a huge congratulations to you for becoming an EA game changer for Anthem. I mean, that's huge. Congrats, good buddy.
It is, thank you. And being an EA game changer, it's something I chased, quote unquote, especially for Anthem Insider, because being an EA game changer, you get opportunities that otherwise you wouldn't have, just such as the hands-on with the game during Gamescom. People who were in the program could do the same thing, and they did during E3. And I'm guessing whatever events are coming up next, you know, game changers kind of get like prioritized or something. I don't know exactly how it works. I'm fresh at this. I'm a newbie at this. But the way it kind of works is there's opportunities for all EA games, Madden, FIFA, Sims, Battlefield, everything. You can sign up for everything if you want. I could make a secondary channel and start covering everything if I wanted to, but I don't have the time right now. My invitation was for Anthem, and I will be focusing on it, but if I at any time I want to do something different, then I do have that option as well, right? They don't exclude you.
Right. It's not only for Anthem Insider, it's for Bags. It's for you, the individual.
Yeah. Yes, exactly. That's what I didn't know. And initially I was trying to apply as Anthem Insider, and I was told to apply as an individual and, you know, have individual accounts behind it, and, you know, a personal email and all that. It's needed for it. Other than that, like, there should be more opportunities coming up. You get things behind the scenes that you usually sign an NDA for, and you gotta keep the embargo. And the reward is, though, is some exclusive stuff, like maybe footage people don't usually have, maybe some image kit that people will not have access to otherwise, things like that. It has its perks, yeah. Definitely.
And I'm hoping all the more and more that I get to become one. I submitted my application, a month ago? And I'm on pins and needles hoping to hear something eventually.
You're going to get in, man. I'm sure.
Well, I appreciate it, good buddy. Now, real quick before we conclude, we're kind of in an Anthem content drought right now, or at least Anthem news drought. Aside from Twitter, we really aren't getting too terribly much. And I think the month of October is going to, I don't know, they're going to release something eventually. Maybe it'll be in October, maybe not. But what's something you want to see or want to hear about or want to get more details on? And don't just say, Anthem in general.
Well, what needs to be shown is more gameplay, definitely. People are asking for it, yes. Like more general gameplay, like for Tarsus or outside of it, or how you run or how you fly or stuff like that. People want to see, you know, details of the game. How is it going to be in their daily gameplay sessions? People want to know about progression and loot. And I know Bernd Irving talked about it and teased. He said he doesn't want to sound like a bot saying soon all the time, but they are arranging something and it's going to be soon. And Bioware soon appears to be like 3 weeks or so.
Yeah, 3 to 4 weeks to a month to a year.
Yeah. we're getting something.
I think
something.
That's become a general...
We're getting something. We got something on September, and it's been a month and 2 weeks. I think at the end of October, maybe, like around N7 Day or something.
Yeah, we're... Oh my god, N7 Day would be great. I'm kind of hoping for more details, maybe not so much gameplay, but details on the systems, like the customization system. We've talked about this at least 100 times. You know me, I'm a real cosmetic guy. I'm probably going to spend 30 hours making sure my suit looks as cosmetically fit as possible so I can feel like a badass while I'm playing as a badass. I kind of want to see how all that works, like the silhouettes that Mark Dara keeps talking about, the customization, the skins, the color options, how you customize your javelin. I also want to see more about the missions and more about the factions. We're long overdue to hear about, what was it, the Outlanders, the Outliers, the...
Outlaws.
Outlaws, yeah, the Outlaws, sorry, Outlander from Knights of the Eternal Throne. We're long overdue to hear some things. Granted, they're doing really good, giving little drops of information over here and there to keep us going, but I don't know. I think the people who want to see the Interceptor, by the way, they've kind of calmed down. They're not jumping at the bits or biting at the heel to hear and see more about them. But ultimately, I think what we need to see more of them, above all else, are the Grabbits.
Definitely want to see more of those. I think... Yeah. The reason we don't see that much is because they're spending resources and time on getting the game polished, right, and done. A lot of things, I guess, they're not exactly finalized yet. As we saw Mark Dara talk about last week, they changed how you unlock the javelins. So they're working on the game. They can't tell you, well, they can't tell us that X thing is going to work like that. And then what if they change it a month, you know, ago, a month later? It's hard, yeah. Like Mark Dara said earlier this year, absolutes are hard, and he doesn't want to promise things that are not going to happen.
Yeah, and I guess that's kind of why they say soon. And I get it. I mean, don't get me wrong, I'm grateful for whenever Mark Dara can answer tweets. I'm grateful whenever anyone says anything about Anthem. It just feels like we would like, I mean, I think that's just the general nature of wanting to know more. We want to know more now.
I mean, it's a highly anticipated game. Even people who are skeptical, they're still keeping an eye on it. And even though, you know, the social media and all the accounts of Anthem, they don't have like millions of followers, they have people who have knowledge of the game existing and on the way and being on the way. I think once people start seeing it, and if we get the chance to live stream it anywhere, right? If Bioware allows streamers to showcase the game, I think a lot of people are gonna like start pre-ordering, because the average gamer wants to see another average gamer play it, right? Or their favorite streamer play it and things like that. Not exactly influencing them or persuading them to purchase the game, more like they want to see, you know, how does Anthem feel if I stay here? Yeah, if I stay here and watch, I don't know, Summit play it for 3 hours straight, right? How does the streamer feel after playing this game X amount of hours? Those things are important. That's why Twitch works. That's why the live streams work. A lot of people base their purchases off of them.
And I think Anthem's making a smart move by releasing it a week early on PC. Most streamers, let's face it, are on PC. And that'll give the console market a whole week to watch it and see, maybe I should buy this, which will only increase their quote-unquote release day sales. But at any rate, this has been Anthem Insider's very own Mr. Baggs. And Baggs, real quick, how can people find your content? Do you have any other platforms aside from YouTube?
There's a lot of social media. The main ones are antheminsider.com, the website. Twitter is at Anthem Insider, and on Twitch, where we do the weekly AI show, it's AI_Baggs. And we also archive those on YouTube, which is YouTube/Anthem Insider.
This has been Baggs from Anthem Insider. Baggs, again, thank you so much, good buddy, for coming on. We've got to do this again soon.
We will, William, we will. And thank you for having me, man.
If you are new to Your Anthem, be sure to subscribe. And if you enjoyed our interview with Mr. Baggs, be sure to leave a like. And as always, a very special thank you to my patrons for all your generous generous support and donations. I hope all of you fantastic freelancers have a phenomenal day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you all in the next video very soon. Peace out, everyone.